these meetings, we will going to discuss a writing task. For this task, this is the first one. So task one is describing bar chart, pie chart, and tables. Okay. Have you ever bought anything over the internet? If yes, what did you buy?
Ini langsung dijawab atau gimana, Miss?
Yeah, I think you can answer it directly.
Oh, oke. Okay. Yes. Wait. Yes, I bought something from internet before.
What did you buy?
Many things actually, from clothes to daily necessary.
Okay, and what kind of things would you order through the internet? Like what you just mentioned?
Okay. Yeah. Clothes.
Why?
And daily necessary. Because I think it's more simple to order it from internet than to go to like a department store or supermarket to buy it.
Right. Is there anything that you wouldn't buy online?
Yes. Actually, I prefer to buy some electronics offline. I don't want to buy it online.
And why do you think some people are nervous about buying things online?
Maybe because they don't trust the platform enough.
Yes, maybe if it's electronic, they're afraid like if it's going to be broken with the
Yeah,
shipping, etc.
or it's fake, maybe.
Yeah, or
That is
if
fake.
it's like shoes, the size doesn't fit them.
Okay.
Which age group do you think makes the most purchases online? Like what age usually?
Yeah. Around maybe teenagers till 30s.
Yeah. So, from teenagers to adult, yeah.
Yeah, to adult.
Okay. So before you begin writing, it's important to understand the information shown in the chart. Look at the bar chart on page 21. Okay, let's see. This is about adult internet shopper and users by age group. So the question, what does the title tell you? Vertical, horizontal, and then color key. So obviously this is the title. What's the horizontal line? Horizontal is this one.
Okay, the horizontal lines is like people based on their age.
Yes.
Group of people based on their age.
Yes, so age group.
Yeah, age group.
And then the vertical line?
Is the number.
The percentage of
yeah, the
shopper.
Percentage of
end
each,
user.
Yeah, it's age group to buy the
yeah.
Some internet. Yeah.
And then the color code, the color based on color.
The blue one is the internet user, and the red one is the
internet
shopper.
So
yeah.
This one only use, and this one actually shop. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
From this information, can you fill in the gap here? From number 1, age 25 to 39, the internet user is how many percentage?
Boleh di minimize, Miss. Okay, 70% and 11%, then number age 25 till 39 around 65%.
Okay, this one 65, and then for 55 plus internet user
20%,
okay.
And the support is around 5%.
All right. Easy, right? For this
Yeah,
one.
it's easy.
So describing general and specific information. Look at the chart A. Maybe you should screenshot this first.
Okay. Wait a minute. Okay.
Okay. So you will describe the chart by ordering the options from A to G. Can you guess which one is number one first? Coba
Wait a minute,
dibaca.
yeah. Let me edit it first.
Okay.
B is number one.
Okay. Maybe you can try to answer all of it first.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Should I write it in chat or just say it?
Yes, you can write it in chat. So like one, maybe one B or one A, one B or one A. Like.
important, Miss.
Okay. Oke, coba dicocokin ya. So, 1 B E F C G D A. Oke. 1 B 4 for the second one, you start with one of the first thing to note. Jadi kalau misalnya awal bikin tulisannya itu yang paling mencolok apa informasinya dari chartnya, makanya yang ini one of the first thing to note. Terus dilanjutin, ini kan masih nyambung, so adding more details. And then another thing which stand out after that, the detail for this other thing, and then a final point to note is that the number of people shopping online does not change very much.
I got it from on number 6 and 7.
Okay. It's okay, we're just doing exercise. Don't try to explain the information, just describe it. For example, don't say why you think more young people use the internet. So if it's something that you just making a conclusion, don't add a conclusion or opinion to task for data like this. So you only write what is shown in the chart.
Okay.
When you describe visual information, you should start with a general overview statement about what the chart or table shows. Then you should choose two or three main features and describe them. Gitu ya. Jadi pertama yang stand out itu apa? Bentar. Okay, so one thing to write, the first one is what really stand out from the chart, and then two or three main feature that you can take from the chart. Each time you pick out a main feature, use some specific detail to support it. Jadi kayak apa yang paling mencolok, terus kayak hal lainnya apa, terus dikasih detailnya sebagai supporting sentences. So read sentences 1 to 5 and categorize them. So here, fewer older people use the internet. 1 until 5. Which sentence are an overview statement? Okay, so this is the graph, ya, Agiska. You can screenshot the chart, the bar chart, the graphic chart. Okay. So for an overview, which one do you think from these options 1 to 5 is the correct answer?
Number 4.
The chart shows how the internet is used by different age group. It looks at both general and online shopping. It's number 6. Wait.
Nggak ada number
6. Yes, there is no one number 6. Wait. Oh, I was taking it from here. No, so not that one. Where were we? So do you think it's number 5? I think I did it wrong. Not this one. Kalau overview kan secara ini ya.
Cara general.
Secara general. Yes, I guess it's 4 ya.
Number four.
Yes. Which sentence describe an overall trend? Secara keseluruhannya.
Number three.
3, yeah, I agree. Okay. Which sentence provide specific detail used to support a main point? Is it this one?
Number five.
Yes, number 5. In the youngest age group, nearly. Yeah, okay. Comparing and contrasting data. You can contrast information using but, however, while, on the other hand, in or by comparison, and in contrast. You can add more information using and also, as well as, in addition, furthermore, and not only but also. Contrast itu yang membedakan ya. Jadi antara dua kalimat kayak untuk nyambunginya bisa pakai but, however, while, on the other hand, in comparison or by comparison, terus in contrast. Kalau add more information bisa pakai and also as well as in addition furthermore terus not only but also. Nah, ini contohnya although 75% of 18 to 24 years old use the internet, only 10% make purchases online. Yang nomor 2, however, only 10% make purchases online. Not only showing general internet use, but also shows in online shopping. It shows not only general internet use, but also online shopping. Information may also be presented as pie chart. The pie chart below shows how one university student spent his money on internet purchase last year. So look at the information in the pie chart and choose the appropriate words to make correct sentences. For number one, he spent more or less money on airline tickets than music. Airline tickets 34, music 18.
More?
Yeah, more, yeah.
More.
That's correct. And for number two, is it very large or relatively small?
Relatively small.
Relatively small.
Okay. Relatively small. For number three, biggest or smallest?
Biggest.
Yes, biggest. That's correct. And then he didn't spend as much money on. Computer software or music? So this one is the
music.
small purchase. This is the big one.
Music.
Music as computer software.
Okay. For this, he spent much more on.
Airline tickets.
Airline tickets. Then entertainment tickets. Okay. He spent slightly or much more on music than on books.
Much more.
Slightly.
Only 2% ya?
Yeah, slightly.
Yeah, okay, slightly. The difference is only 2%. Okay, he spent a great deal or a little on airline tickets?
A great deal.
A great deal. Paling banyak ya, 20. Berapa sih? 34%.
34.
Okay. Write your own comparative sentences to describe the data in the chart into A, and for B, include wrong information in some of your sentences and then show them to your partner. Bisa dibandingin nggak yang ini, chart yang ini sama yang ini? 2A, the first one, what is it about? And then compare this one with this one. You can make, I give you an example. In chart 2A, the internet users are both male and female, while in chart 4B are only male. You can include wrong information as well. So you can write it down. Maybe type it in the comment Google chat. Okay, the same, yeah. It's already correct. Let's move on to academic writing task 1. Spend 1 or 2 minutes studying the chart until you understand what it is showing. Explain what the chart is describing in your opening sentence. Then identify 2 or 3 main features. Don't describe everything you see. Look for any interesting features, especially surprising or contrasting information. Start with an overall description and then move on to use details to support your main points. Remember to use expressions such as in addition and however to link your ideas. Remember to leave time to check your work before the end. So this is the title or like the sentences given. The chart below shows the different types of goods and services purchased online in Australia, Canada, and UK last year. Write a report for a university lecturer describing the information below. So there is this chart. Okay. I think before you write this exercise, you can take a look at YouTube video, wait. So this is my example for the opening of the paragraph. So you can start with the chart below shows the different types of goods and services purchased online in Australia, Canada, and the UK last year. One of the first things to notice from this chart is the UK has the highest online purchase compared to Australia and Canada. I think you can continue that. Wait. But you have to watch the YouTube video first. Yeah, I sent in the chat box. For this exercise, I think you can write it in Google Docs. So you can share the link of the Google Doc after you done writing for this one. The minimum is 150 words. For this, do you have any question?
Sir, I need advice for setups.
Sorry?
Is there any deadline for setups? So we do it now or can we do it later?
I think you can if you can finish it for today. I'm waiting for you to send it. But if you need more time, you can submit it until maybe the weekend.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So I guess that's all for the Google
study.
Meet. Yeah?
Miss?
Yeah?
Miss, suaranya hilang. Kita nulis essay soal chart ini.
Yeah, you have to like make a Google Documents. And then you can write down the task, minimum 150 words. If you have done, you can share the task to me.
Tasknya tadi
yang ini ya, you should spend 20 minutes writing at least 150 words describing about this chart. Before you write, please take a look at this YouTube video that I sent a link on the Google chat box.
Okay, thank you, Miss.
Okay. So if you have any questions, you can ask me through chats. Good luck with the writing. So I'm going to end the Google Meet, yeah.
Okay, thank you, Miss.
Okay.
Good evening.
Good evening.